Hey everybody, welcome back to Cook Serve the Delicious. My name is Bear. We got a deal, a bet with Crazy Dave. He thinks we can't make more than $500 in income today, so obviously gonna just make him eat his stupid crazy words. Crazy dumb idiot, more like. That's what his name should be, totally. Don't have any catering options at the moment, unfortunately, and we're probably not gonna take this bet because I'd have to buy potatoes for it, and I don't really like potatoes, so not gonna happen. I actually managed to get a decent score on the staple menu as well last time for that steam challenge, so that's pretty solid. I'm gonna throw the soup back on here as well as the fish lasagna. Let's throw in the chicken breast, get the steak, and let's get salad on there as well. So we got a pretty decent buzz for today. 67%. Can't be too upset with that, and yeah, that should basically do it. So we're really close to that second star, actually. In fact, I'm pretty sure this might be the day. So, you know, get sufficient amounts of hype for that. I won't tell you to get excessive amounts of hype. I think maybe we should keep it tampered just a bit. Get our, you know what we really need to do is start preparing for the kind of, posh attitude that we need to have when we get into that 3 and 4 star range. We gotta start really discriminating against people strongly at that point. No more will we allow Mr. Wifebeater, 5 o'clock shadow to come by here ordering his fish at 9 o'clock in the morning. No, sir. At that point, I will be, well, I'll probably not really have much control over whether or not he comes in, but I hope that he feels like, damn, I should probably clean myself up and not, you know, just come in here without a hat and wearing a different shirt, trying to pass myself off as somebody else. Instead of just coming in here and ordering 2 separate meals within the span of an hour. Because I totally won't notice. I totally won't see that. Dumbo. I saw him. He's a Dumbo. So that's probably a different person. I'll give that dude the pass, but I'm watching, man. I'm watching, learning, and listening. All at the same time. It doesn't really seem like the greatest way in the world to do things, but damn it, I'm doing it. I cannot wait for click and start as well, man. I am so ready to get these big upgrades. The big changes need to be made in this scene, man. We also need to make a shitload of money today. $500 is the goal. Shouldn't be that big of a deal. Shouldn't be too difficult is really what I mean to say. 4 and 5 and 1, all gone. Look at all that cash. Look at all that cash. See, we're already getting there. This is great. Also, of course, trying for that $250 perfect day bonus, which I think is totally reasonable. I'm also realizing how dumb of a dummy I was. Not getting that audio balance sorted out beforehand. Hopefully that's in proper standing for you guys today. Chicken bliss for everyone, yes, sir. Delicious, delicious stuff. I'm loving the opinion stuff. The opinionated responses we're getting, by the way, to all the those interesting little conversations we're having as a part of our Cook Serve Delicious endeavors. Appreciate you guys continually supporting the series. Much love to all you beautiful, beautiful people. Not really sure an atmosphere I would go for, though. This is just, I'm giving myself a very odd segue into what I wanted to talk about here. If I were to actually own a restaurant. Because I don't think it's anything I would ever do, honestly. I mean, like, this is giving me a very realistic interpretation of what it would be like to, bonga hype! What it would be like to really do something like this. Because even in my current occupation, I suppose, is what you would call it. I find myself obsessing over the little things time and time again. And to do that in a scenario where you're dealing with giving people food and such, that would result in, I think, quite a few nights up into the wee hours of the morn, wondering what you could have possibly done better through the course of that day. What if I had just listened to Bald Beardy's request, given him the lemonless fish he so justly deserved? What is wrong with me? And then I would just sob crying cry. But no, I really don't think I'd be able to manage a restaurant in my actual life. Just that kind of stress, man. I know a lot of people have made note of the fact that the life of a server is not a fun one, nor I imagine is the life of a chef. Although, I know that's the kind of profession that people seek out. It's like the end-all be-all goals, like being a chef at a five-star restaurant. That's gotta be so stressful, but I guess it's worth it, isn't it? It's gotta be worth it. I don't know. Is there anyone out there, anyone among you, whose real aspiration in life is to be a five-star chef of some sort? Because I would be very interested to hear about what your aspirations entail, what kind of obstacles you foresee. Maybe there's no one like that. Entirely possible as well. I think we've managed to clear our goal for Crazy Dave's bet. I believe we've already gotten $500 in sales, so that's fantastic. That's another $600 we can utilize at the end of the day here. We also might get ourselves that perfect day bonus. It's looking like it. It's looking like things are going our way. Got some tips today as well. Looking good. Looking good. You see this guy? Yeah, he's trying to play a game with us here. He's trying to game the system. That ain't flying under my nose, pal. You take your soup and get out of here. I don't like the way you're handling your life. Way too much food in it. That's really a big problem. You wouldn't think that would be the kind of thing I'd judge somebody about, but damn. Look at me go. Look at me judging people. So effortlessly. Admirable, is it not? There we go. I have a lot of trash today, my goodness. Creamy potatoes. I don't know what it is about that dish. Maybe it's just the little cubes. The cubes of potatoes that look so plump and moist. Entering the broth. Plump and moist entering the broth. That is just some suggestive language if I ever heard it, Bear Taffy. Let me tell you what. One short of the perfect day again. What a bummer. What a bummer. And this steak, he's back again. This steak is gonna just, take so long. Take so long. God, there we are. All right. Believe we've done it. Yes, indeed. $972. And that sound means we have achieved two-star glory. Congratulations on completing all of your goals and tasks. We thought we'd remodel your restaurant and set up some new goals for you to achieve for the next star rating. We've also enrolled you in a few new restaurant programs, so keep an eye out for those emails. Good luck and keep cooking wonderfully. Hello, swans! Cranes. You know, birds. Welcome to the brand new restaurant! And an endless celebration. Beautiful. We've done it. Totally overhauled the restaurant for the new look and feel now that you're certified as a two-star. Hooray! New atmosphere. Customers will be a lot more patient. Very, very nice. Oh, I accidentally clicked something else here too. Whoops. Oh, that must have been Crazy Dave's bet. Okay, apparently you can click through this menu here to read other emails. I had no idea that was the case, but just want to say I love you. Love you too. Thank you. Perfect day for $250 bonus. Very nice. Got a weather alert today as well. Should be good for the buzz. My sensors indicate you have upgraded your restaurant once again. I have added all 10 specialty foods into the restaurant. Have a good day. Have a good bed. There we go. The Iron Cook Kitchen has just released some new specialty upgrades and new foods, so be sure to check it out on the upgrades and view by food specialty menu. Sweet! From Chef Marinara. Now the new prep station, extra customer per day, that gets us up to 6, I believe. Your upgrade to a 2-star establishment has changed the way your customers view your restaurant, which means cheap snack foods will no longer be ordered by customers. Oh, okay. So we can no longer serve pretzels and corn dogs. Luckily, we weren't ever doing that in the first place, so very good. Okay, what kind of equipment can we purchase here now? I don't think there's anything really. We can buy the mail filter, but I kind of like having the, I kind of like having the spam options this time around. This looks like something we can do, but that's not really a big payout, so I think I'm actually going to hang on to my silver ticket this time around. Let's look at what we can upgrade here. Upgrading that chicken breast, of course, is always a solid idea. This gets us up to a $15 ticket price. Same with the steak, or a little bit more, and there's a spicy pepper dispenser on board with that as well. Huh. We can bump up the burgers here as well, get us up to 2-star burgers. Pretty sure I do want to... Actually, you know what I should do is buy the wine. Should definitely look into getting this. Ends up being very, very, expensive in later upgrades, so... I think I want to start into the path of upgraded wine, and I'm also going to upgrade the burgers here. That looks like a solid option. And then we get up to 12 bucks for the burger at some point as well. Can't quite afford that one, but we are on our way. On our way to greatness and glory. We are a 2-star restaurant now, and it looks like our menu actually might be about the same today. Let's go ahead and throw burgers on there for funsies, though. Let's take off the, I don't know really if we want to take off too much. Taking off steak isn't really going to do us any favors, but the burgers, you know what, steak's more expensive anyway, so we might as well do that. We'll put salad on the daily special, throw the fish back on. Nearly 100% buzz today. This should be really good, actually. Let's go ahead and get it going. Should be a real solid day, and we're up to 6 possible orders at a time now, so that'll be good. So that'll be very, very good. I'm very curious to see what kind of income we can look forward to today. We can get just a smattering of orders. Chicken and steak for everybody at the beginning of the day today. Very, very interesting. I'm actually kind of surprised. I was expecting it to be quite a bit busier than it is right now, but I guess we're gonna take a bit of a leisurely approach to the 2-star lifestyle. Not quite sitting pretty on Madison Avenue just yet, are we? Alright, this is garbage. I know how to do things. Yeah, I guess it's gonna be slightly slower to start off the day. 6 orders total, man. Come on now. I'm ready. I can handle the big league. Let's do this stuff. This crane's freaking me out though, man. Kind of wish that was just an initial celebration phase decoration. Not necessarily sticking around for the long haul, but... Alright! Guess we better start getting used to him now. I think I got that one correct. There we go. The first rush hour here. First rush hour of the 2-star life. Shit! I already ruined it. Oh no, okay, well... That's terrible. Throw a bunch of cheese on there for you, pal. How's that? I think I might have actually ruined that soup, too. There we go! That's what I'm looking for. That's the style of salad we like to serve around these parts. Very nice, very nice. Okay, one season, twice juicy, and serving of citrus. Actually did get that one correct, so there we go. Very, very good. Chicken noodles, seasoned potatoes, carrots, and cabbage. The Batistobo is not one that I see all too frequently, but I'm very happy to serve it. Alright, yeah, things are going a little bit better now. Getting a little intense, but I am ready. And that lemon, baby. And we're making a good amount of money here now, man. This is real solid. Bonga hype! Let me see some bonga hype. Bonga hype in the comments. May I please have just a little bit of bonga hype? I know I asked for some hype before, and I should temper my expectations, but... Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Oh, God. Oh, no. Oh, God. What have I done there? What in the world was that? Oh, that was just a mess. That was just a mess of a lasagna. Look at that thing. Oh, Lordy. I absolutely wrecked that one. I want to personally apologize to that customer. That was just abysmal. Good Lord. All right, no more of that. No more of that's gonna happen, I guarantee it. All lasagna's perfect for the remainder of the series. That is my bear taffy promise. As you all know, a bear taffy promise ain't no promise like a bear taffy promise, because a bear taffy promise gets broke. That's what they say. That's what the kids are saying these days. Well, no perfect day, unfortunately, but I suppose that's to be expected with the transitionary period, right? That's the excuse I give myself. Look at those big old chunky potatoes. Big old chunky taters. Yummy. Oh man, I really need to upgrade my steak now, man. Apparently a lot of people really want to order this thing. And with good reason, because it looks fantastic. Buzz boost is going to be very solid here as well. And the lemon, we are nearly at 100% buzz, which would be awesome. We can, of course, oh god, I think I ruined that one too. Have I already broken my lasagna promise? Oh my god. Bonga hype again, and another buzz boost. Okay, so there it is, as I was just about to say, you can go over a 100% buzz. My god, look how quickly I broke that promise. I am the worst. Oh no. That was so bad. How am I already getting so bad at the lasagnas again? That was my pride and joy, the slab lasagna before. What is happening to my world? Oh god, that was three red. Okay, oh man, yeah, I'm completely losing it now. I am totally losing my edge. Alright, let's see if I can, redeem myself. There we go, that one felt good, that one felt nice. Felt like a winning combination there, that lasagna. Very good, okay. Excellent. Getting back in the swing of things here. Bam. Wait, it was carrots, celery? I always love to just chop random vegetables, switch it up for myself. Keep me on my toes. I owe that to me, right? Yeah, I definitely need to upgrade this steak, man. This is a very popular dish for a 2-star restaurant. You are back? Oh my god, I thought I got rid of you. Damn it all to hell. How is he still ordering at this restaurant? This is an outrage. This is a pure burgundy blood red boiling mad rage inducing situation. And he's back with a hairpiece. God dang it. I'll never get rid of him, will I? I'll forever haunt my dreams, the 5 o'clock shadow. I'm just jealous because I don't have a really proper 5 o'clock shadow. Honestly, that's a redeeming quality of a man right there. I use that to insult the guy, but damn if I'm not jealous of it. You get a solid 5 o'clock shadow on you. People know you mean business. Well, actually, that's kind of the opposite of what that means, isn't it? I don't understand facial hair. I just grow it. I'll make the facial hair, I just grow it. That's what I say. That's my phrase I use. Alright, yeah, we're making a solid amount of money here, man. Unfortunately, not gonna be, in steak upgrading range at the moment. But the overall income's looking pretty good. Alright, so our new goals here. 20 days of service, 18 combo in 5 days, 3 in safety inspections, and then 5 out of 7 catering options. Menu rot is occurring. Hooper shares up at 40 today. The drought over the nation's major burrito farms has driven demand for this company sky high. Zell Buitt shares down 11, and Aaron Shu has struck the CEO of this company, causing him to forget the secret recipes he kept to himself for so long. My goodness. There's a baked potato upgrade available as well. Crazy Dave's bet, you seem to be a good chef, but I don't think you're a good bartender. Well, you made 20 combos today with a beer on your active menu. Yeah, I can do that, Crazy Dave. Do you remember what the name of my restaurant is? You are in for a world of hurt, my friend. Taking this nonsense out of here, getting all that beer up in this bitch. Yes, sir. I'm gonna throw the burgers on here as the daily special here, too. And tell you what, let's just fuel everyone's rampant alcoholism and get some sugary stuff in there for the kids. Day full of beverages, how about that? You are on, Crazy Dave. Oh, it is on. I'm ready for the extreme situation here, man. I'm gonna serve up some beers like nobody's business. And get that wine on the menu. Some salad just for balance. Burgers, because they're good. Come on, man. Not everything needs a reason. Jumbo Flavor Blast Cola. Yum, yum. There we go. All right. It's time for a perfect day here. Time for a perfect day. What better way to celebrate a perfect day than with the PD? Meat, bacon, and pickles, croutons, and ranch and cheese. All kinds of deliciousness to be served here in the Cook Serve Delicious. How fitting is that? Oh god. Oh god, no, I accidentally put chicken in there. Oh shit, well. Damn it. Oh well. Oh well, that one's done. Reach to go for the cabbage. End up accidentally throwing chicken in the dish. You know how that is. That's a common enough occurrence to warrant referencing, right? At least I believe so. My god, my finger is so sore from all this ridiculous wine. It's too much. Too much wine in this restaurant. I am not a fan of me deciding to put that on the menu. What is wrong with me? Alright, here we go. I'm getting Vietnam-esque flashbacks of my all drinks challenge day. That was a hoot. Oh god, I put the freaking... Oh no. Oh man, I'm starting to worry. We have not yet met Crazy Dave's combo bet. Oh god. Am I gonna be able to do this today? It's almost a real concern. There's those quick dishes. Okay, that makes me feel a little better. Jumbo grape with ice and flavor blast. We can do that. Meat only on the patty. Boom. Meat only on the patty. Yeah, that makes a lot of sense. Can I get some patty with a little bit of chicken and floor crumbs? That would just be delightful. Thank you kindly. Look at all those nines up there. That's a fancy little look. And I ruined it. Turn it into some people's birth year. Is your birth year 1997? Or 2007? God, some people were born in 2007 that could be watching this. That's bizarre. That is baffling, in fact. I would go so far as to say. I don't know if you can really comprehend a lot of what's going on. Oh my god! I just served them an undercooked meal! Wow! I've actually failed to meet the combo again. And now I'm really starting to get concerned. That was fake concern before, but now this is real. Can I do this? Can I meet Crazy Dave's bet? I'm really starting to, what they would call, throw right now. Two meat patties on the Heartstopper. Oh, goodness. Well, just try your heart out, man. Here we go. Oh, God, more buzz. That actually might be what we need here. Get that buzz going again. Holy crap, okay. I can do this. Don't accidentally put chicken in the dish again. That'd be terrible. Ranch and cheese, flush the toilet. Pop the cork. We only need a few more. We can do this. We can do this. Send that out. Small water with ice and flavor blast. Totally normal order. Don't even call attention to it. Flavor blast in the cola. I'm getting there. One more! We got it! Oh, man. Oh, man. I was getting concerned. I was getting concerned, but right before the, rush hour, we managed to grab that Crazy Dave combo. Oh, man. I'm so happy. I did not miss out on that opportunity. Oh, that would have been so terrible. I got it, though. We're good. Everyone can relax. Get down off of your pitchforks. What? Not how that works, Bear. Not how that item works. Okay, here we go. Bonga hype again. Beautiful. Eat the lettuce. Da-da-da-da! Excellent! Excellent. Oh, goodness. Oh, no, but I throw... What in the hell did I push? I put... What is N? What is N? For the soup? Whatever that is, that's how I ruined that dish. Oh, God. Oh, I didn't ruin it. Oh, good! Okay, wonderful. By the Stobo again, we got more buzz boost. Excellent, okay. Happy with that. The Heartstopper. Aptly named. There we go. Another soup order, small cola with no ice, no problem. Send number 5 out, get another Brian Davis on the grill. Oh yeah, we got a good combo going now, man. That feels nice. Meat, bacon, cheese, and tomatoes. Yum, yum. Meat and tomatoes on here. Meat, lettuce, bacon, cheese, tomatoes, and pickles. Yummy. The meat patty. We're making a decent amount of money off of these burgers today as well, man. This is feeling pretty good. jumbo water with ice and flavor blast. Oh my god. Yeah, you get a jumbo diet with ice and flavor blast. You're kind of defeating the purpose of that diet drink order, I would imagine. Okay, take care of these wines first. Always take care of the wines first. Unless you want to do them second. Or, you know, some later item in the progression of things. I won't judge you. I'll let you do your thing, man. It's your restaurant to control. I'm not the supreme leader of beverages. As much as I wish I could be. One last soup and wow, that's actually a pretty solid combo, regardless of how many we dropped before. Which means we probably got like 80 or 90 orders today. 100! Wow! 103! Okay! That's pretty solid. Not bad at all. And we won Crazy Dave's bet as well as 600 bucks. Tax return accepted, $50 to the account as well. Free simple web test to see if your information has been pilfered. Enter your credit card number at extension 299 and we'll tell you it's been stolen, huh? Ooh. Ready to meet some people who share similar interests in cuisine and fine dining. And you've enrolled in the right dating website. This is Cook for Love, a program that partners up fantastic cooks with salivating diners. You have chosen category Chef Looking for Love. So you will receive emails from people looking for delicious dishes and romance. Please choose an option below and watch your inbox for love letters. I want to date women. Alright. Cool. Well, that's fun. I'm going to date some women, I guess. Thanks for watching this episode of Cook Serve Delicious. I'll see you next time.